हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग। एम आई ऑडिबल? प्लीज कमेंट। फाइन, नाइनटीन मेंबर्स हैव जॉइन्ड। आई एम लुकिंग फॉर गुड स्ट्रेंथ। ट्वेंटी वन मेंबर्स। ट्वेंटी सिक्स मेंबर्स हैव जॉइंड। फाइन, आई विल वेट फॉर अनदर टू मिनट्स सो दैट द स्टूडेंट्स कैन जॉइन। 28 मेंबर्स। फाइन, why it is reducing already? I told you I'll start within 2 minutes. Strength is reducing. It is 26 now. Earlier it was 30. Okay, let us start the class. So today we'll be discussing on the bolted connection. As I said already, we have discussed on the offline class also about the bolted connection. Only the thing is that we need to solve the problems. Before going to that, okay, what exactly the bolt? And this one is a nut. This one is a obviously what happens, especially in bolted connection. These are two components, bolt and nut. Okay, here you can see the half threaded bolts. Okay, bolt is half threaded. This one we call it as the threaded area up to this length. We call it as threaded area. And this one we call it as the shank area. Okay, these are the two major important things will be used, or these will be come into picture when you find the shear capacity of the bolted connections. Okay, here what happens? Here in this we have the caudal provision for bolted connections. Here you can see in the figure. If it is not visible, make the video quality up to 720p. Okay, here the first thing is that shear capacity of the bolt. Okay, so VDSB is equal to VSB divided by gamma MB. Okay, you will be calculating VDSB is equal to VNSB divided by gamma MB. So here what happens? Based on this, I'll be calculating the capacity of this one. Whereas VNSB is calculated, this is the shear capacity of the bolt. Capacity means, okay, suppose if the two plates are connected using the bolt and nut, here what happens? Because of the load applied on the plates, there is a failure at this point. Okay, that is, we call it as the shear plane. The failure will occur at the shear plane. Okay, so then the failure occur at shear plane, obviously before going to using these type of bolts for the applied force, we need to find out the capacity of bolted connection, or we need to find out capacity of the bolt. When you are calculating the bolt capacity, okay, all you need to calculate is VDSB, first one shear capacity of the bolt, and the second one is the bearing capacity of the bolt. Okay, bearing capacity, here we have bearing capacity of the bolt, clause number 10.3.3 and clause number 10.3.4. it is there in IS 800, page number 75. Whereas VNSB, it is calculated as FUB divided by root 3 into bracket NSASB plus NNANB. okay, NS means what? First, Fu is ultimate strength of the bolt. FUB is nothing but, okay, here in the code book it is written as FU. Please write it as FUB. Okay, so here FUB is nothing but ultimate strength of the bolt. Okay, that will be might be Fu 400 bolts will be used. Okay, of grade 4.6, something will be using, right? The grade of that bolt is to be mentioned here. Okay, whereas NN is nothing but number of shear planes with the threads intercepting the shear plane. That means if your plates are here, okay, on the threads, okay, shear plane is if it is on the threads, okay, or you might be using the full threaded bolts. In that case, how many number of shear planes are there on the threaded area? Shear planes means if the plates are connected here in this position, I'll show you here. If plates are connected in this position, okay, the shear plane is falling on the threaded area. If it is falling on the threaded area, obviously what happens? Okay, there is a one shear plane on a threaded area. That is nothing but NS is equal to the NN. First one is NN. Okay, NN is equal to number of shear planes with the threads intercepting the shear plane. Whereas NS is what? The number of shear planes without threads intercepting shear plane. That means without threads means if the plates are connected on a shank area. Okay, in this case the shear plane is different. Okay, here we'll be getting the shear plane, right? Okay, so what we'll do? We'll be going for the NS value. That is, NS will come into picture. That is 1 into the area of bolt. Okay, here ASB is nothing but area of bolt in shank area and area of bolt in the thread area. Okay, here what happens? Suppose if the plates are connected on the thread portion, this is thread portion, okay, on the thread portion, in this case what happens? Nn become 0.78 times Anb. Nn is nothing but 0.78. Okay, Nn is equal to 0.78. And always Ns will be equal to, Ns will be is equal to 1. Okay, so if the shear plane is on the shank area, in that case the Ns value becomes 1. Okay, especially what happens, actually the area or a die of bolt is calculated here. If it is M16 bolts, M16 means a 16 mm dia bolts we are using. Okay, and if the M16 bolts are using and its a thread area will be only 78% of the total cross section area at the shank, that's why we are taking 0.78. Okay, so here what I will do, okay, Nn and Ns will be calculated based on the where exactly the connection is happen, whether it is on the thread area or it is on the shank area. Okay, depends, based on that we will be finding value of Nn and Ns. Okay, I think you understood. Whereas Asb and Anb is nothing but the area of bolt. Okay, Anb, Asb is the nominal plane shank area of the bolt, nominal plane shank area. Shank area means this is Asb, at this we will be calculating Asb, and whereas at threaded area, okay, area of threaded is Anb. Okay, so where exactly the connection will happen, based on that we will be finding value of Nn and Ns as well as Asb and Anb. Okay, especially when there are only two plates. For example, I will be taking example here. If this is a bolt, half of this is threaded area. I will take another example. Okay, if there are, if there are only two plates, if it is connected, it may, the shear area may fall on the shank area itself. Okay, so here the shear area may be here. For example, if the connection is of three plates, if we made a connection of three plates, in this case one shear plane is on the shank area and another shear plane is on a threaded area. Am I audible? Please write your comments. Are you understood or I need to repeat? Okay, write it in a comment box. Are you understood what exactly the threaded area, shank area, where to take Nn, Ns? Am I audible? Please respond in a comment box. Soil Patel, please explain once again in a bold. Okay, repeat once. Okay, fine. Okay, here what happens? I'll repeat once again. Here, okay, this is the bolt and nut to be used for the connections of the steel structure. Okay, here in this, whenever you use two plates, for example, if you are using two plates, what happens? Okay, I may be connecting plates up to the end. Okay, if I am connecting a plates, okay, plate may be the plates, the or the shear plane maybe falls on the shank area. Am I right? I cannot connect the plates on the threaded area. Only if you are using or if you are connecting only two plates, okay, you will not be able to connect these plates on the shank area because the remaining gaps can't be filled. Okay, so here what happens? Okay, this, for example, the second plate, I'll repeat once. If it is, this is the first place to be connected, and next one is the second plate is to be connected here. Okay, if you are connecting two plates, so obviously one plate is taken up to the head of the first plate, is taken up to the head of the bolt, and next plate will be connected to the parallel to that. That is okay, only one shear plane will occur if you are using the two plates. This is the only shear plane. Okay, here you can see the shear plane. Okay, this is the only shear plane. Right, okay, if this is the only one shear plane, obviously it falls on the shank area. As I said, this is shank and this is thread. Okay, it is only the shear plane falls on a shank area. Okay, for example, if I am using another plate. Okay, if you are connecting three plates using the bolt, okay, this is the connection of steel structures. Okay, if you are using only two plates, or if there are two plates to connect using the bolt, in that case, the shear plane falls on the shank area. Whereas, if I am using three plates, okay, one shear plane will be fall on the shank area and another shear plane will fall on the threaded area. Okay, here you can see in the figure, okay, there are two shear planes. Okay, one is on the shank area and another one is on threaded area. So the number of shear planes on a shank area, this is NS becomes 1, and okay, this one NN becomes 1. Okay, so if it is on a shank area, threaded area, NN becomes equal to 1. If it is on the shank area only, in that case NS becomes 1. Okay, if only two plates you are using, NS becomes, if there are only two plates, there is no plane on a threaded area, so NS becomes 1 and NN becomes 0. Okay, NN will become 0. Okay, so we will be using those values here. Okay, and ASB is equal to what? Area of bolt in a shank area. ANB is equal to area of bolt in a threaded area. Okay, ASB is equal to pi by 4 into d square. This is 0.78 times. 0.78 means this is the NN value. Okay, NN will put here. Okay, so NN equal to NS ASB is equal to 1 into pi by 4 d square, or NN ANB is equal to 0.78 times pi by 4 d square. Okay, you understood? Please write it in a comment box. Okay, fine. I think you understood. Okay. Now, here what I will do, once if it is completed, the next step is what? The bearing capacity of the bolt. Okay. Whatever the bolt capacity is there, okay, that should be more than this one. Okay. Only we are calculating the capacity of the bolt. Okay. Among these two, the shear capacity and the bearing capacity, another one is there, tension capacity. Okay, that will be very less as compared to these two. So, among these two, which one is the least value is, whatever the least value we get from these two will be taken as the capacity of the bolt, okay. So, one bolt capacity, for example, okay, where exactly we are using this one, okay. So, here what, this is a gusset plate. I am connecting an angle to the gusset plate. Okay, you might have seen the truss, okay, truss members. In the truss members, what happens? There is a connection of member along with the gusset plate, okay. So here if the 100 kilonewton is applied, the factor load which is applied on the member, and this is a gusset plate and this is the angle section, these are the two separate members to be connected using bolts. For example, among these two, VDSB and VDPB, if we are getting a value of, if we are getting a value of, that is bolt value means the capacity of the single bolt, if it is 35 kilonewton, if it is 35 kilonewton, that means the capacity of one bolt is 35 kilonewton. Okay, to resist the 100 kilonewton, you will be using how much? 100 divided by 35. Okay, it is around something 2 point something will be there. 2.8, 2.9, whatever. Okay, so I will be using 3 numbers of bolts to connect this one. Okay, the main intention to calculate the capacity of the bolt is to find out the number of bolts required to resist the connections or resist the applied forces on the connections. Okay, here in the truss member, the 100 kilonewton tension is applied, whereas to resist 100 kilonewton, one bolt capacity is 35 kilonewton. This is a factor load 100 kilonewton. Capacity of one bolt is 35. So to resist total 100 kilonewton, how many bolts are required? There are 3 numbers. Okay, so here we'll be using, okay, the number of bolts or the bolt value or bolt capacity will be come into picture. Okay, especially when you are in the calculation of, or when you are designing the steel structure. Okay, there are, as I said, there are two types of connections. One is welded as well as the bolted connection. First, we have taken this as a first part. Okay, so this is a welded connection. This one is a bolted connection. Later, already we have I have shared some videos on the welded connection also. Okay, you can go through that. Okay, I'll repeat the part welded connection once again. Okay, so especially in the bolted connection, only these two steps need to be calculated. Okay, so here what I will do, okay, I'll be using these two equations to find out to find out the capacity of the bolt. Okay, first what we'll do, we'll be calculating the capacity of the bolt. Okay, I'll be taking an example to find out the capacity of the bolt. Okay, for example, two plates to be connected using 4.6 bolt grade. These are the grades of bolts. Okay, I'll let you know in the next session. Okay, using M16 bolts of grade 4.6 to be used to resist 150 kilonewton on the plates which are in tension. Okay, this is the connection of plates. Okay, I'll show you. Two plates are connected. There is a force of 150 kilonewton on either side. Okay, obviously, we will be getting the same force to bring it in a equilibrium condition. Okay, so here what happens? Okay, now I will be calculating the threads may be up to this. Okay, whereas this is the condition, we need to find out how many bolts are required to connect these plates. Okay, I'll show you the plan also. This is the connection. Okay, 150 kilonewton is applied. Okay, how many bolts are required to connect or resist this 150 kilonewton? To take thickness of these plates is equal to 10 mm. Okay, both plates are of 10 mm. Okay, so here what we'll do? Okay, if it is a 10 mm plates and take this width of plate is equal to 300 mm. Width of plate is equal to 300 mm. Okay, this is the problem definition. Okay, we are going to find out the number of bolts required for this connection. So here what I will do, I will be finding first VDSB. VDSB is equal to FUB divided by gamma MB into bracket NN ANB plus NS ASB. I'll be finding the shear capacity of the bolt. Here gamma MB is the factor of safety for the bolted connections. Factor of safety for bolted connections. So in this, it will be is equal to around 1.25 will be taken, the factor of safety. I'll let you know in the next class. Okay, in the next session, we'll be discussing about these things once again. What is factor of safety? How much will be taken? What types of bolts are available? And what grades of bolts are available? Where exactly you need to use? Okay, so it is a briefing class. Based on that, I'll be solving a simple problem on this. Okay, here, first I'll be calculating FUB. FUB is nothing but 4.6 grade. Okay, that is nothing but FUB is equal to 410. Okay, you may take 410 or 400. Okay, I'll tell you how exactly these values will be taken. Okay, so here I'll be taking FUB is equal to around 410 or 400. Okay, here I'll be taking 400 itself. Okay, make it 400 bolt value. Okay, the yield strength of bolt, okay, that is equal to 400. Gamma MB is equal to 1.25. now You only tell me whether the plane is on the threaded, the shear plane is on threaded area or shank area. Write it in a comment box. Sadiq, sir, what if shear plane is lying on the threaded area? What will be the NS value? NS value become 1 itself, whereas if only on threaded area, it is not possible. Okay, only the plate, the shear plane falls on a threaded area, it is not possible. Obviously, this will only happen when you have the three plates. Okay, one will be, first preference will be on the shank area itself. Okay, because okay, you'll be placing plates up to the head of the bolt. Okay, I cannot able to fix the plate on the threaded area intentionally, right? You just watch the figure carefully and tell me where exactly the threaded area is there, on the shank or on the where exactly the shear plane is there, on the shank or on the threads. If plate is more thicker, sir, then it will fall on a threaded area accordingly. The if plates are more thicker, okay, I am not able to use the short bolts, obviously, based on that, because there is a space required for the nut also, okay, fitting of nut also. Okay, that's why I'll not be using short bolts. Okay, obviously here what happens, whenever you take threaded the bolt, half will be the threads and half will be the what, half will be shank, right? If you use the plate of thicker, obviously the same thickness may be here. Okay, sometimes it may not be here. Okay, I require some space for the fitting of this nut also. That's why in that case, what I will do, I'll be using the longer bolts. Okay, if it is so, you take NS is equal to 0 and only you take NN. Okay, that is the rare cases. Okay, those are the rare cases, right? This one is shank area, fine. You understood? Fine. Okay, now what I will do, if it is if the shear plane is fall on a shank area, NN becomes 0 because there is no shear planes on a threaded area. So A and B, it is pi by 4 into 16 square, plus NS becomes 1 because one shear plane is there. Okay, so no need to reduce the area, it is multiplied 1 because the shank area of shank area is 100%, whereas area of threaded area is only 78%. Okay, so that's why, okay, if the shear plane is on the threaded area, okay, NN becomes 0.78, right? So here 1 into ASP is nothing but area of bolt on a shank area. Area of bolt, dia of bolt, how much you are taking? M16 bolts. M16 means 16 mm dia I am taking here. So M16 bolts I am using. Okay, you calculate and tell, anybody calculate and tell me the value. Please anybody calculate and tell me the value of this one. How much you got? Anybody got answer? Eighty-one. Check it once. This becomes 0, right? This becomes 0 means only pi by 4 into 16 square, right? Into 400, is it 64.33? Okay, you will get value in this one newton. You need to write it in the kilonewton. 64.33 kilonewton. Sadiq, fine, you are right. Okay, 64.33 kilonewton. So here what I will do, one capacity is get calculated here. Okay, so in the next step I need to calculate capacity of the VDPB also. Okay, here you can see VDPB is equal to 2.5. okay, this equation, okay, 2.5 kbdt into fu. This equation will be used. Okay, VDPB is equal to 2.5 kbdt fu divided by gamma mb. Fu here it is what? KBDT FUB will be used here. Okay, so here what I will do, at the end I will be calculating VDPB also. VDPB is equal to 2.5 KBDT FUB divided by gamma MB. Okay, this is the equation to be used to calculate bearing capacity of the bolt. Okay, shear capacity and bearing capacity, okay, both will come into picture here. Okay, VDPB will be calculated based on these equations. That is, KB is what? Okay, we'll read out. KB is 'the smaller of these things, E divided by 3D naught, P divided by 3D naught, minus 0.25, FUB divided by FU, and 1.0. Among these four values, which one is the least value? Okay, this will be taken as what? This will be taken as the value of KB. Whereas E and P, edge and pitch distance, will be calculated. Okay, this is nothing but I'll tell you what exactly the edge and pitch distance. Okay, pitch distance is equal to 2.5 times the die off bolt. Edge distance is equal to 1.5 times the die off bolts. Okay, this will be used to calculate KB. D is nothing but, okay, D is nothing but D naught, or D is nothing but what? The D is the diameter of bolt. Here we have KBDT, it is diameter of bolt, and we have D naught also. D naught is nothing but what? Diameter of hole. Okay, obviously what happens if you are using diameter of bolt is equal to 16 mm, diameter of hole DH is equal to how much? It will be around 18 mm. There is a chart for finding out diameter of bolt hole. Okay, especially for 16 mm, diameter of hole will be D naught is equal to how much? This is 18 mm, 2 mm more than the die of hole. Okay, next one is FUB. FU, you know this one. D is diameter of bolt. Okay, I'll substitute all the things. Okay, here what happens? 2.5 D naught, how much it will be? Anybody calculate 2.5 into 16, how much it is? Anybody calculate 2.5 into 16? Okay, it will be 40 mm. Fine. 1.5 into 16. 1.5 into 16 is equal to how much? 24. Okay, I'll be taking 24. I'll make it round off. Okay, edge distance is equal to 25 mm. Pitch distance is equal to 40 mm. Okay, here what happens? Okay, what exactly the edge and pitch distance? I'll let you know. Here, this is edge distance, and one bolt to another bolt, this we call it as the pitch distance. Okay, this is P and edge distance are E. Okay, here in the figure you can see edge is nothing but this one, from the end of the plate to the first bolt and end of the plate to the last bolt, we call it as edge distance. Remaining the distance between the bolts, we call it as the pitch distance. Okay, I think you understood this one. Please write it in a comment box whether you understood or not. E is equal to 24. Yeah, yes, fine. Sohail Patel, Arif Ahmad, Zamir, Jeevan, fine. Only 27 members are remaining. 39 members, fine. Okay, next will be what? Okay, you know these values. KB DT, okay, I'll substitute here. 2.5. Okay, KB need to be calculated here. Before that, KB will be calculated. Okay, there is four clauses are there. E by 3 D naught, P divided by 3 D naught minus 0.25, FU by FU and 1. Okay, so what I will do? I'll go to this one and I'll be finding value of KB. First one is E by 3 D naught. Second one is P by 3 D naught minus 0.25. Third one is FUB divided by FU. Third one is FUB divided by FU. FUB is nothing but the ultimate strength of bolt. FU is nothing but ultimate strength of the plates which we are using, right? Fourth one is 1.0. Least KB is the least of these four. Okay, E is nothing but 25 divided by 3 into D naught is 18 mm. Okay, if D is equal to 16 mm, D naught or DH diaphole is equal to 18 mm. Calculate this one. And P by D, P is nothing but 40 divided by 3 into 18 minus 0.25. Calculate this one. FUB is 400 and FU will become 410. The grade of plates which we are using. Okay, this will be equal to 400 divided by 410. Okay, and this is equal to 1.0. Okay. So calculate this one. Which one? First one is 0.4629. Okay, Jeevan, fine. Is it correct? Check it once. Right, 0.462, fine. Second one, the first one is 0.46. Okay, you take two or three digits, 0.46. Second one, 40 divided by 3 into 18 minus 0.25. Second one is 0.49. Third one, 400 divided by 410. 0.97, and last one is 1. Okay, among these four values, which one is the least value? This one, 0.46 is the least value, right? 0.46 is the least value. Right, fine. Okay, so I'll be using this KB is equal to 0.46. Next, D, you know, T is equal to die of port. What is T? T is there, right? T is nothing but what? Okay, I'll go to the code book. T, what he mentioned? Here he has mentioned about the T. Okay, read out this statement. Summation of the thickness of It is nothing but the summation of the thickness of the connected plate experiencing bearing stress in the same direction, or it's a bolt or countersunk, the thickness of the plate minus one half of the depth of countersunking. Okay, no need to worry, it is nothing but the thickness of the thinner plate. Thickness of the thinner plate will be taken into consideration. Thickness of the thinner plate among these two plates will be considered. Okay, so here among these two plates, what is the thinner plate? This one is also 10 mm and this is also 10 mm. Okay, so the T is equal to what? Thickness of the thinner plate is equal to T is equal to 10 mm itself. Okay, D is equal to what? D is equal to 16 mm. FUB is equal to 400 Newton per mm square. And gamma MB is equal to what? 1.25. Substitute these values in the equation. PDPB is equal to 2.5 KB DT FUB divided by gamma MB. When you substitute, 2.5 into KB is a 0.46, D is a 16 mm dia, T is thickness of thinner plate 10 mm, FUB is 400 divided by gamma MB is 1.25. When you calculate, VDPB will be getting value of VDPB. When you calculate VDPB, nothing but 2.5, 0.46, 16 into 10 into 400 divided by 1.25. How much you got? 58.8 kilonewton. Is it right? Check it once. Anybody please check. Is it 58.8? Fine. Okay, G1 correct. 58880. It is in Newton. When you convert, you will be getting it in kilonewton. 58.8 kilonewton. Okay. So, here what I will do? 58.8. Among these two values, that is, first one is VDSB is how much? VDSB is 64.33 and VDPB is 58.8. VDSB is 64.33 and VDPB is 58.8 kilonewton. Okay, so as I said, the bolt value capacity is nothing but the least of these two. Okay, so I'll be taking this as a capacity of the bolt, or the bolt value 58.8 kilonewton. Because if I think that the capacity of bolt is 58.8, when you use appropriate number of bolts, okay, the applied force will be, maximum applied force on the one bolt will be 58.8. okay, so it will sustain what? 64. If you think that 64 is the capacity of the bolt, okay, if you take this value, what happens? Okay, if I apply 64, it will fail under the bearing. Okay, it will be safe under shear, but it will fail under bearing. So the bolt value is the least among, that's why I said the bolt value will be taken as the least among these two values. Okay, this is the bolt value. Okay, next what I will do, I'll be finding the number of bolts. Number of bolts for the plate connection. Okay, number of bolts for plate connection is nothing but what? How many number of bolts are required to connect this one? Okay, in this figure. Okay, so applied force is 150 kilonewton. So it is nothing but, it is in tension, that is TU by bolt value. TU is nothing but 150, the factor load. 150 kilonewton, okay, write it in kilonewton itself, divided by the bolt value is there, 58.8. okay, how many bolts are required? Please calculate. It is equal to 2.55. am I right? Check it once. 2.55. okay, Arif, 10 to the power of 3 can go. Like, both the values are in kilonewton, right? 150 is also in kilonewton, 58.8 is also in kilonewton. Why should write 10 to the power of 3 on both the sides, right? 2.55, okay, fine. So this will be equal to how much? Three numbers. Right? Three numbers of bolts are required to connect the plate connection. Right? So here what I will do? Okay, again I will go for the connection of these plates. Right, there are three bolts required. Okay, three bolts are required to resist the 150 kilonewton applied force. Okay, so in this way we will be calculating the number of bolts for the connection. You understood the concept? I think you understood the concept. If it is yes, okay, write it in a comment box. And or you can click on like button so that I can understand that you are getting the concept. Fine. Muhammad Umar Gautam Samshir, okay, Sayed Sujata Jameer Savita, fine. Swail Patel, fine. Nisarga, fine. Bhogendra, fine. Yes, Ganesh Babu, Jeevan, Sadiq. Akshata. Shweta, Somning, Ashapri, fine. Tarif Ahmad. Okay, anything else? Any doubts? Please. Okay, Ahmad Khan, Swarna Kavya, Addictive Zone. Okay, Addictive Zone. Write it. Write your own name. Sabir Chaudhary, Amog, Nohan Alur. Okay, I shared a link of another YouTube channel of my friend. Okay, that may be helpful. Okay, he'll be visiting the sites and he'll be explaining, okay, about the civil engineering. If you want, you can subscribe that channel. I shared in a comment box. Okay, so until then. Thank you. We'll be discussing on the next class about the remaining things about bolted connections. Okay, until then, thank you. Okay, if you have any doubts, please write it in a comment box of this video itself. Any doubts in this? Any doubts in today's class? Any doubts in today's class? No, fine, Mama Sohail Patel. Thank you. Out of 43, 44 members, only I am getting comments of 7, 8 members, right? No, sir. Somning, Sabir, Samshir Alam. Fine, I think you understood the concept, okay? We'll be discussing more things about the bolted connection in the upcoming classes. Thank you.